Come get your lunch. Want to eat, sir?
One of our friends, one of our leaders, was sleeping in a place on Crown Street right here for 2 years with permission, okay? From the property owners with permission. He's been sleeping there every night. And yesterday, out of the blue, some guy came out from the rental office taking pictures of him, and then he immediately called the cops. And what did the cops do? They said, take all of your stuff immediately with you and leave right now or you'll be arrested. This is, now, when you sleep in a place for 2 years, I don't care what the law says, that is your home. Hey guys, who's hungry? Step up if you want food, folks. I can talk while I'm serving. Come get your lunch, Lucy. Hi, Patti.
You know, I have the chance to take up this torch and do something about it, but not everybody is that lucky. So I am deeply connected to what's going on here today. And, you know, when I heard about what happened to Keith, it immediately is like, that's like almost the same thing that happened to me. They didn't even let him take his stuff. It was literally, get out right now or you're going to jail. The man had been living there for 2 years.
Emergency is tonight.
What do we want?
Justice.
When do we want it?
Now.
Shame.
Today.
Shame.
Today.
Shame.
Shame.
How dare you treat our neighbors like that? How dare you? 2 years. 2 years this man had a home, and you threw him out in 5 minutes. 1 minute, one moment he's a neighbor. The next moment he's a criminal. Answer for yourselves. How dare you? Where's the property manager? Come out here and talk to us. Stop being cowardly.
Housing is a human right.
The emergency is tonight.
My name's Mark Colville. I'm part of a UAC, Unhoused Activists Community Team. And we're here today because we've had enough. We are fed up with people being treated like subhumans, simply because they can't afford to live in an apartment. We've had enough. And Keith here is going to tell about what happened to him yesterday. He's your neighbor, folks, so listen to him.
Hi guys, I'm Keith. I've been here for 2 years. Sleeping in this spot right in the art gallery. The people from the art gallery give me the Wi-Fi. They bring me food. People, neighbors that bring me food. Neighbors stop by, have conversations. One day, taking a nap because of my sleep apnea, resting before actually one of these meetings, and all of a sudden, I get a guy taking pictures of me that is so-called the property manager. When I went to confront him about why he's taking pictures, he ran into the office and I hid. Got on his phone, called the police. And then the police showed up and told me I had to leave where I was living. They said, you're trespassing if you come back. You gotta take your belongings now and leave. I've been there for 2 years. So if you want to talk, we can talk now. We can talk quiet, or we can talk loud. You understand? I'm a human. You could have talked to me like a man. You could have talked to me like a person that I am.
Housing is a human right.
The emergency is tonight.
This is public land. We're allowed to be on the sidewalk. Right now we're here protesting, and there's a police officer over there on his phone talking to the chief of police, making sure we're on the sidewalk and we're not blocking the street. Housing is a human right!
The emergency is tonight!
I have been unhoused. I am housed now, but I remember what it's like, and it's not easy. And people are people at the end of the day, and if you believe that, I would believe that's why you're here.
They're not gonna find you.
They want the homeless people to go away. That's what they want.
How are you gonna get away if you don't give them a home?
Well, how can they go somewhere if you're not giving them nowhere to stay? This is why we got so many homeless people have nowhere to go. So what? They don't look like we look, but they are somebody. They are.
You want the megaphone,
no,
man?
No,
I know you got a voice,
no,
but you can put yourself crazy.
If, like I always said, if I had my way, if I had my own organization, I would open up a house for, come, go as you please and come back. That's what I would do.
Yeah.
These homeless people, they don't bother nobody. Not at all. Give them a break. You want them off the street? Give them somewhere to live and stop playing with them. Y'all have a blessed day.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Come here. I want a hug. Can I get a hug?
Yes, you can, baby. Yes, you can.
Thank you.
God bless you, baby. God bless you. You're in my prayers.
I know a lot of people in this very building that was once homeless. And I would say to those people, for just a little while, leave the comforts of your home and come stand with us. And I see absolutely no reason for the peacekeepers, which usually gives us no peace whatsoever, except they do give us a piece of steel and a piece of bologna sandwich and maybe a little juice when they incarcerate us for being homeless.
Make sure you're charged, so we don't run in there.
Make sure you lock the door.
Make sure we get out there.
It's locked.
Like most of us are locked out of the housing market because you cannot afford it.
Oh, yeah.
That's right.
So the question is, do you really care about the homeless? I mean, it's easy to say that you do, but saying is an action. And I guess that's why this organization is called You Act.
Yes.
And I guess that's my question for you today. Will you act on our behalf?
Yes.
Will you stand with
us? Yes.
You most certainly can.
Why are you out bothering Ninth Square? Excuse me.
Ask him.
I got told to leave the property. Can I ask you why
you're out here at Ninth
Square?
You can talk to me.
No, I'm not talking to you.
Yeah, you should, because
I'm not talking to you.
I
want to know why you're here at Ninth Square.
We're telling you why we're here. He was evicted from a place he was living at for 2 years.
Here at Ninth Square?
Without being spoken to.
Here at Ninth Square? And you know this is affordable housing.
Hey, how you doing? Okay. Hey, how you doing, sir?
We're
gonna let you guys do what you guys do. Just don't block people from.
We're not blocking anybody.
I'm just letting you know.
We're not lying about anything. We're being very courteous.
So let everybody.
We're here because we want to meet with him.
We want to meet. He don't want to talk to me.
He has a right to be told by the manager.
Can you move up a little bit, sir? Yes, please.
He has to be armed.
Yeah, sir. Arm distance. Please. Okay. All right. So, like I just mentioned to you, okay?
We actually had many encounters of talking.
No, you remember me last time I came down here?
Not Daniel. We also saw you over there with a bike.
Yeah. We're just monitoring the situation.
Huh?
We're just monitoring the situation.
I was thinking about it. That's fine. But we're not allowing anyone. We're not doing the scab thing.
Okay.
Everyone can walk freely as they want. They can say whatever they want, but the guy didn't want to talk to me like a man yesterday.
Right.
He just called you guys for no reason. He could ask himself, he could have a conversation with him about whatever the problem was. I got no issues with that, bro.
Don't care about the unhoused, guys.
Thank you, folks. We are beautiful and we are powerful.
Woo! Woo!
All right? We are beautiful and we are powerful. And we keep coming back.
That's our power, okay?
Now it's 12:30. Our original plan was to go back now to City Hall and walk in and knock on the mayor's door with the same message we brought here. But before we do that, I know that Keith wanted, all he wanted was a conversation with these people, okay? And so we're gonna give it one more try. Keith is gonna ring the doorbell here and see if they have the courage to come out and justify or apologize for their behavior towards their neighbor. And if not, we will shake the dust off our feet right here and we'll go back to City Hall and keep the protest going, okay?
Yes.
We are beautiful, we are powerful,
yes.
And we keep coming back.
We'll be back.
Come out and talk to our neighbor, Keith. That's evil for you. It gets done in darkness all the time.
So
it never gets talked about
never.
By the people doing it.
And they burn so bright, while you can only